Hello guys, welcome back. As you can see, I have varnished the bowsprit, also painted these parts here. These two were metal, if you remember correctly. And I'm ready to make the holes, to place the rings, and of course a lot of pulleys. So, and some ropes here, definitely some ropes. So, let me gather my materials and I'll get back to you. And guys, I've gathered all my materials. Let me show you something. I have some blocks here. They're marked as D. This is the single pulley. The small one has only one hole. Also, I have some pulleys here that are marked E. These are double pulleys. I have two holes, and also I have these big ones. I have five of them. The rope here is the number 195. Is this brown 0.5 millimeters? And I'm going to use also for the pulleys this. This rope that it's the 0.15 millimeters. Also, I have the rings here, all the rings that I need. All the rings goes right here. We have three this side, three the other side, one at the bottom, one at the top. I also have to make some holes. Here I have one hole, another. Here we have a couple of holes. So I'll start by making the holes. Here also we have some holes. These holes are all 1 millimeter, and I'll start by making the holes. Then I will place the rings, the ropes, and at the end the pulleys. And definitely I'm going to place the entire construction onto the boat, on the ship. Sorry, but before making anything. Here I have a 0.9 millimeter tip, and I'm going to take every pulley, and I'm going to open up the hole just to make sure that it's going to be easy to pass the ropes through. So guys, let me do that because it's a little bit time consuming. And I'll get back to you to make the holes and place the rings. So guys, let's start by making first the holes for the rings. I have to place three rings here. One goes exactly at dead center right here. Do not need a deep hole, just enough to make the ring stay. And we have two more holes here, that one goes right there. No need to measure. Just by the eye, it's a very small surface and you have a lot of reference points. And the other one goes a little bit lower. Also, I have to make exact the same holes on the other side, and I have one hole here at the top, dead center, and one at the bottom. At the bottom, I'm going to place it right here because it's very difficult to do it in any other spot. Now, let me make three holes over here too, and I'll get back to you. Now, let's make the 1 millimeter holes. As you can see, this is the way this goes. I'm going to place it the other way around. This is the end. So I have one hole right here. One hole right here and two more, one here and one here. Also I have four more here, but let's start by making these holes. This one is, let me see, it is centered, so I use 1 millimeter drill tip. This is hard. Now, let's place the rings. Now, the rings, as you can see, are like this one, like this side here, also the other one. They must be facing like this, and also the up and down, you'll have to be able to see it, the ring from the side. Before proceeding to place any pulleys, I have to open these holes here. So again, 1 millimeter drill. Have to make one right about here. So we're ready. Now I have to place ropes and pulleys. Let's start by making, by placing the ropes. I believe it's better. So what we have here is a rope around this part here, and also we have to place ropes here, 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 here and here. Here it's more clearly. So let's see how many lines of rope we need. We need 10 lines of rope. 10 10, also 10 10, and here maybe 10, but I'll have to cover the entire space. So the rope we're going to use is this one. I'm going to place the first one, and the others are exactly the same. But before placing, let's make sure that we have the right position. here we have the cuts, as you can see. So here is one, here is the other, and here is the third. Here it's a vertical view, so we have an angle, so this is wrong. I have to measure it here at the side. So let's measure again. Here's one, here's another, here's a third. The other ones are easy because I have reference points. So let's place the first one here. The first thing I have to do is make a simple nut to make the rope stay where I want it to. I prefer the nuts to be at the bottom. So they're going to be less visible. Let's put it a little bit. Okay. It's difficult, it's not easy. Some glue to keep it in position. Now, I have to make the rope to pass 10 times. I hold the rope like this, diagonally, and place some glue over here and over here to secure it. I also cut the excess ones. And here's the first one. Now, I'll do the exact same way the other ones, and I'll get back to you to place the rest of the stuff. And here we have all the ropes. Looks beautiful. Now, let's place these things first. These ones are going to be tied with the same type of thread. We have two here, sorry, we have one here and one here, and also underneath, and one in the middle. So let's do the first one. This must go like this. The point, the pointy edge will go all the way to the this side where the ropes are tied together. That's where the pointy edge should go. So first of all, that's it, and I have a lot of rope to spare. Some glue. Now again, some glue here. Quickly twist. And got it. Now, according to the plans, the first one goes here. Let's center it. Like this. Some glue to secure it. And now to tie a knot. Simple knot. Nothing serious. Just can hold it. Some glue. And done. Easy enough. Now, with the same way, I'm going to do the other four. Nothing different, just the middle one. Needs a couple of turns with a rope, like you see here in the drawings. So I just have to leave more rope to make a couple of turns. So let me do that, and I'll get back to you with a finishing result. And here I have it, guys. Three underneath and two on the top. Pretty beautiful. Now, what's left to do is to put on all these pulleys. There are a lot. I'm going to use the same technique as before. So, I'm going to make one to show you how it is done. I'm going to use this type of rope. Like I said before, it's the 015. Take one pulley, hold it like this, put some glue, some glue here, and quickly twist. That's it. Now all I have to do is tie it over the place it should go. So I'm going to repeat the process for all these. I'm going to place them over here, nothing to worth filming about it. It's like this procedure, exactly the same, but with different ropes. And I'm going to show you the finishing result. And finally, it's done. As you can see, all these pulleys, the rings, the ropes, everything is on according to the plans. I'm definitely sure that in the process of rigging, some rings or pulleys may be needed later in the future, but that's not a problem. I can add anything whenever I wish. Now, the next step is to place this onto the ship. To do that, I'm going to need some white glue for wood, this one, and also this rope. It's the string. It's brown 0.8. So let me get the ship here. Let me adjust the camera and I'll get back to you with the mounting. So guys, it's time to mount the bowsprit. First of all, let's check out if it fits. It fits, so we have no problem with the holes. Second, I'm going to use some white glue, like I said before, because I need to have time to twist it, to move it around. And I will secure it later with some cyanoacrylic. Right. Sorry for that. So let me check if it's centered, because I cannot do that on the camera, and I'll get back to you to tie it down. Now guys, let's tie it. Like I said before, I'm going to use the 0.8 brown thread, rope, call it whatever you wish, and I have to tie it here and here through these gratings all the way through these holes. The ropes I'm going to use is exactly as the length of each of these two holes, so that's not a problem. What I do not know is how long should I cut this thread, so let's begin and we'll find out in the process. Sorry for that guys, I have it, I just wanted to find a way on how to pass it through, so I'm going to show it to you. Just let me use some more rope, because I don't think it's going to be enough. Now, from top, bottom. Got the wrong one. Here's the right one. Pass it through again. Got it. Now that's the way. So let me make that and I'll get back to you when it's the final moment that I'm going to tie it down. Now guys, as you can see, I have made all the passes. Now, to tie it, this piece comes underneath, right here, takes a turn around here, and comes right here, but I'm passing it under the same rope that comes underneath, so to keep it in the center position that I want. Also, I'm pulling it to be tied like this, and I'm going to use some glue here to secure it. What I'm going to do now is make this piece goes around to have some turns. Like this, and now with this piece I'm going to tie a knot right here at the center. Like this. Some glue to secure it. Cut the excess rope. And the first one is ready. I have to do the other one the same way. So let me do that and I'll show you the finishing result. And this is it, guys. Of course, we have a lot of tying to do. This must be tied somewhere around here. Also, we have to place a lot of ropes and I believe 2 yards. There's a lot of work to be done. But the bowsprit is mounted onto the ship. And I can tell you, it looks amazing. So, thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon with the next step, which is to begin making the masts.